classes are a mandatory activity in all of our FAMs because it is a great opportunity for travel advisors to get to know our world-class chefs and also learn something. Today, I'm very happy to be with the executive chef of the five-diamond restaurant Cocina del Tor, Naum Velasco. Hola, chef.
Hola, Dinora. How are you? So, today we'll be preparing some cheese lollipops. This is a quite representative dish of our culinary expressions at the restaurant. We will need some cheese. In this case, it's Parmesan cheese. Okay. So, and I have mixed nuts here, some dried apricots, freeze-dried pineapple, and freeze-dried banana. The last ingredient that we have, it's freeze-dried raspberry, but powdered. I have a tray and a silicone mat, some bamboo sticks, and a cookie cutter, a circle cookie cutter. And we need some spoons and a spatula, okay? I have the cheese in really fine sheets. You can ask at your shop to leave it that way. So now let's cut. I'll put 3 to make it easier. I'm using the bamboo sticks, just using the tip on the downside, okay? We'll take the nuts. The idea of this recipe is to have a cheese platter on a lollipop. Cheese platter on a steak or cheese platter on a lollipop. So, usually what's in it? Cheese, of course, some fruits, maybe olives. We can use black olives. We can chop or slice black olives and put them in the middle. Or if you like stronger flavors, maybe some blue cheese crumbs also in the middle. And so you have a different kind of lollipop, a different kind of flavor. This is great for a cocktail, for a small reunion. And you can mix with your favorite wine as well. Then the second and more important part is to have the other part of cheese on top and leave it like that, just leave it to drop. So with the heat of the oven, it will stick like a ravioli. So now that we have them ready, we go to our oven, just enough time to stick together. We have to be looking at it because it depends on time of the thickness of the cheese. Okay, so now we have our lollipops almost done. And so now it's time for use our raspberry powder before cooling down. The raspberry will add some acidity. When you have acidity, so your tongue starts producing more saliva, and saliva is a vehicle of flavor. So when you have more saliva in your mouth, you can have a more tasteful meal. Okay, so now that they're completely cool, we took them out from the fridge, and now we can put them in our glasses. I'm using some marbles, but you can use any seed. And make sure to leave them outside of the fridge at least 20 minutes before eating, so they're more tasty. And that's it, they're ready to enjoy.
Great, thank you, chef. They look delicious and super easy. So do not forget to come to a cooking class, and especially if it's with Chef Naum Velasco. Thank you, bye.
Bye.